Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. If you like this content, please consider subscribing. So, in today's video, we'll have a look at how to do this thing. So, in this video, I'll show you how to fake rack focus using DaVinci Resolve 16. So, let's get right to it right now. Let's go. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 16, and this is a super easy trick to make a rack focus. So first off, I'll hit my viewer button on my control panel so you can see the shot. So this is the shot we are trying to work with. It's a decent shot, but we can make it a little more interesting. So let's do this. Okay, let's go to the beginning of the clip and let's go to the color tab. And in the color tab, we could give it a grade, but we're not going to do that. So let's go to the color tab and let's go into the mask and then choose a curve. And then we can zoom in a bit with using the scroll wheel and we'll just do a mask pretty fast. Okay, and so I'll do it very fast for the sake of this tutorial, but you can use more time on making the mask super duper. Okay. So there we go. So the next thing we will do is are going to track the clip, just tracking it super fast as well. So now we have done our first thing. The next thing we are going to do, we are going to take this footage here. And then we are going to blur it out, basically. So that's just going here and then dragging it outwards. And now it's very blurred out and it's too much. So if we go back to our window, we can change it a bit. And it's easier if we actually click off the mask so we can see what we're doing. So we're going to go to the softness and then putting some inside and outside, and we're going to soften that out a bit. And then I think we're going to make it less blur, something like this. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do, we're going to go back to the edit tab, and then now we have this clip here, and we'll just pause there, and then I'll just cut this in two bits, and then we'll go to the color tab. And now we're on the second clip here, and in the second clip, I'm going to right click on this and go down to add a node, and I'm going to add an outside node. And what outside node is, it will take our node here and invert it, so the selection will be after this node. So we'll just go in here, and here we'll, first off, we're going here to the first node, and we're going to our blur, and we're just going to take the blur down to null. Then we're going to the second node and we are just going to add the blur here. Something like that, maybe a little too much, something like that. Okay, and we'll just zoom in here and fix a little issue. So we'll go to the beginning of the clip here. Again, I will take off the power window, going into the power window, and I'll take off the power window, and then we're going to take off some of the softness. We are going to take off some of the inside, some of the outside, and a little bit of the softness. So we want it to be as close to the border as possible. Like that, maybe a little softness. Good. And then we are going back and we'll just track that mask once again. Okay, then we'll go to the editing tab and we'll click between our two clips and then we'll just do Control T and we'll do a transition and we'll just make it a little larger. And then we'll go to the beginning of the clip and I'll push my viewer button and here we go. So You can work by making the mask even better than this, but this was just very quickly for the tutorial. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.